Hi everyone, welcome back. I'm Snokus, and this is another episode in our Hearts of Iron 4 Kaiserreich campaign. So last time we did some meddling in our domestic politics, make some decisions with some events and stuff like that, and this episode we're gonna continue organizing our army here. One thing I want to say is before I do this is that some mechanics are locked in this mode, as for example you can't let's see here, boost party popularity, for example, and some other stuff. All right, election day 3, the internal security. Chevalier Charles Rapoport has resigned his post of delegate for internal security to compete for the foreign affairs post. Former chairman Marceau Pivert, still hoping for his political future, has managed to be endorsed by the Chevalier wing, fighting the stern Jacobin Maurice Torres, Sorellian General Marcel Bocard, and young Macnos disciple Maurice Yosseau. Whatever. Okay, so essentially we can gain map power at the cost of political power. The opposite. A bit of a... or two different... different lesser choices here. We're gonna stick with the syndicalist for now, gaining some manpower, shoring up our military before the war. We are not producing enough military equipment. Infantry equipment. Although it's not really optimized yet, so it will probably go up quite a bit. Okay. Nice. Alright, so this front is somewhat secure for now, I'd say. I'm gonna, you know what, let's get this over with. Today's election, which is election day 4, the economic affairs, seems to be a plebiscite about the economic policy of the last years. Many visions of the syndicalist economy, more or less concentrated on industry or agriculture, are fighting each other, all of them being crucial for the future final struggle against Germany. Okay, so do we want, so this is pretty much, we choose which of these we want through an event instead of a focus development. So, orthodox syndicalism, industrialization, war economy, agriculture, or cooperatives. And I'm not gonna read the different buffs here, but you can see them for yourself. This is pretty good due to higher factory output. And this is pretty good due to a very high population recruitment factor. I think we're gonna stick with the orthodox syndicalism. We get 4 factories and we also get a higher recruitable population, which isn't that big of a boost, it seems, but still. Let's try to shore up our infantry equipment production. On the 3rd of February 1936, the Berlin Stock Exchange stopped sinking, it plunged. Fueled by the instability of the market panic, selling erupted as soon as the stock market opened on Monday morning. It took well into the night for the teleprinters to stop, sparring out the result of what become known as the Black Monday. When the results have been analyzed, it's clear that the situation has become desperate overnight. Question mark? Alright. Anyway, let's find some more. There are mountains here, right? There are quite a lot of mountains, so let's send all of these 6 divisions over here. I'm slowly trying to...
Attention.
Okay, so he's a field marshal anyway. I'm slowly but surely trying to fix up our army here. It's gonna get done someday. Election day 5, foreign affairs. By the way, the mod isn't all like this. After the initial events and your direction essentially has been chosen, it gets a lot less events further on. With the final election day, one of the leading issues of the commune France is raised, diplomacy, which carries the double task of spreading the revolution throughout the world and preparing for revenge against Germany. If the very existence of the Syndicalist International is not endangered yet, the future theaters of the world revolution will be defined today. Okay. We can get internationalism, world revolution, revenge against Germany, or European socialism. This is not popular. Well, let's go with internationalism again then. And then let's try to get this done in time. Okay, so Afghanistan decided to attack. Here's Afghanistan. Yep, it is. They decided to attack the Dominion of India. And the Dominion of India is allied with all of the overseas dominions of the what used to be the British Empire. Okay, I don't know why I did that. Okay, let's go with that guy. Let's... Right. The results: Travelier majority. Even if many saw in this election the end of the Travelier compromise that had ruled the commune since the death of Emile Poguet, they managed to secure a firm majority during these elections. Even if Pivert could be recalled, at least, which is very unlikely, everybody's looking forward to the Russian emigre Boris Sovereign, born Sovereigne. I'm really sorry. To lead the commune in its final glory. So we can recall him and get... So we can either get the Russian or the this guy. Yeah, sure. Congrats, comrade. Alright, and we seem to have some more. Alright, so there's the Fifth Anglo-Afghani War. Alright, so pretty much England and France, well, not even England, but English monarchy, I suppose, through the Dominion of India is at war with Afghanistan for the fifth time. Anyway, let's also... create an offensive line just to make sure that we build up that offensive bonus there with planned preparation. Cool. So we're gonna have some low political power for a while, but it's not the end of the world. It's not at all the same like the vanilla game. During the inauguration ceremony of the new Comité de Salut Public at the Bois General de Travail, HGT Chairman Sébastien Faure has announced he would propose his resignation, as many claim that the internal division within the executive branches of the commune, Faure is an anarchist, was the primary cause of the political crisis. The two favorites to succeed him are both rather peaceful men, Léon Joha and Benoît Frachon. Okay. I don't see how it matters, but alright. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna try to advance to this river, which is a pretty defensive point, and then we're gonna pretty much just wait there as a staging point, and then we'll see where we go after that. Let's create a bit of a... Actually, we have some more infantry here, which we do need. Let's create somewhat of a blitzkrieg unit. We're gonna need this here, so let's use this engineer guy. Crap. Alright, sure. That's gonna have to do. And then we make a spearhead up to Liege. This is the kind of thing I wanna avoid. I want them to only have the front of one province, but they refuse for some reason. Right, that's gonna have to do, I guess. So if war breaks out, we charge right in and cut off these units from the German lines, and hopefully we can wipe out what they're called, the Flanders Wallonia, pretty quickly. Here are some more infantry. Let's add them to the Italian Defense Force. This is my attempt at Fronte Italia, sure. My attempt at entirely uneducated French. I don't know what... What am I trying to do here? I don't know what Germany is in French. So... I'm gonna try that, because I know that Alemania is Germany in Spanish. Okay, the remilitarization of Oltenia. So armed forces of Romania has moved into Oltenia despite the Bucharest Treaty of 1918 forbidding them to do so. So this is pretty much the alternative, what's it called? The alternative remilitarization to the German remilitarization in the real World War II. I imagine you figured that out yourself. It remains to be seen whether they will uphold the other stipulations of the treaty. I imagine they won't. I don't know who Romania had that agreement with, but I'm sure that's fine. There also seems to be a demilitarized zone here in Italy, which I imagine is between Austria and Italy. Okay, so let's create another Blitzkrieg unit. Okay, let's just grab a guy. Where do we want this guy then? Well, we could try to pull some stunts here in Germany. Let's speed up the time a bit. We've gone slow enough for a while now. But I imagine a better thing would be to... I don't know, maybe put him here and try to charge here in the critical pocket here. Or this way could work as well, although they have a port here, so... I'm just gonna get this done first. Okay, nice. No, that's not at all what I wanted to do, is it? Yeah, it is. Don't want to do that, though. Sorry, this is a bit finicky. Come on. That seems good enough, I think. Can I just drag this down a bit? Yeah, that's good. That's really good. Right, and whoops. I want to put both of these guys on aggressive. And the other two on careful. Careful means they won't charge into forts unless they are really outnumbering the enemies. And aggressive means they're gonna attack no matter what and hopefully push through. Alright, anyway, the Troisième International, maybe. We have been preparing for the Third International since 1927. Now we are nearly ready to hold the first Congress right here on the Montmartre Hill in Paris. Built on the ruins of Sacré-Cœur. For the 3 days, the city will host delegates from almost every socialist, syndicalist, and Bolshevik party from all across the world. We, the French, will take the floor first. That is, if we are still planning on hosting the first Congress and continuing the work of the Second International. Yeah, let's do it. I don't see why we wouldn't. Except sucking up the Germans, but fuck the Germans, right? Sorry, any German listeners. Sorry about all the reading, by the way. The first international congress. Representatives from numerous syndicalist and socialist nations have gathered in Paris today, in what might just be a defining moment in the history of the ideologies. The French Commune has invited numerous countries to the first official gathering of the members of the Third International to discuss political foreign matters and cooperate on the spreading of socialism further. The French opened the International with a powerful parade, festivities in Paris, and finally a speech by the chairman of the CSP. Topics like Spain, the United States, and the world economic crisis are at the top priority, and it's expected that France and Britain will take initiative in the gathering. That sounds fine. Okay, so new focus then. And yep, let's go with that. Let's see here. We still have a bit of a backup here, a deficit here. Let's make sure that we do this. Our constructions are going fine, but it's gonna take a while before we get through all of the civilian factors, but that's actually kind of good. Anyway, do we want proletarian infantry or proletarian with fire support? Well, I know what I'd want. Let's just see here. They have artillery pretty much what I guessed. Let's go with we can go with a few without fire support as well, I guess. And then let's also get some marines so we can maybe invade here or in Italy if that happens. And let's get some mobile and some cavalry. You know what? Fuck cavalry, because they're gonna take our infantry equipment. Okay, how many do we want? This is with fire support, so let's get like 5 maybe. Maybe 3 regular proletarian. Marines, we want 5, 6 at least. And then like 6 motorized for now. Let's not put any location on anyone, just want to be training for now. The first Congress of the Third International. It is time to invite socialist and syndicalist leaders who will be coming from around the globe to attend the first Congress of the Third International. Send out the invitation. And a lot of nations are gonna get the Third International, and hopefully they will all attend. Let's keep increasing our research time here. Cool. And we're finally in the positive again. The chairman of the committee, the salut public, takes the floor. Now that everyone seems assembled in the Congress, and the Congress has begun, it's time to take the stage on the open discussion. The Prime Minister took the stage first and discussed the purpose of the Third International. After the purpose of the Third International is made more clear, the discussion will begin. I won't say no to more political power. Don't know what MacLeod is, but can't. Okay. MacLeod seems to be a Chinese state. And as you can see, the Germans have a subject here in China. Don't know the background for that, but they do. Clan of Mongolia seem pretty evenly matched there. Okay. Syndicalism in Spain. Joaquin Ascaso Podría has taken the stage and elaborated the position of the CNTFAI, which, if you don't know, is one of the syndicalist worker unions or trade unions that fought for the Republic in the Spanish Civil War, which we are doing a separate campaign of, if you want to see that, of the real World War II, that is. They are made up of anarcho-syndicalists, moderate syndicalists, and trade unionists. The Spanish revolutionaries have been seen white terror, violent counter-revolutionary actions taken against the right with the workers firsthand. They have come asking for support for their cause when the moment comes. We will pledge support, of course. We want to see a liberated Spain, don't we? We can add some companies here, and as you can see, there are a lot more choices and a lot more symbols than the real world game or the vanilla game. But before we do that, we're gonna take a cut here and end the episode. If you want to see more, please leave a like, and just if you want to support me, leave a like as well. It helps a lot in gaining attention on YouTube. And consider subscribing if you want to see more. And yeah, I hope you have a nice day. Thanks for watching, and hope I'll see you next time. Bye.